Now we will listen to the second reading.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Be ambitious for the higher gifts, and I'm going to show you a way that is better than any of them. If I have all the eloquence of men or of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are, and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but am without love, it will do me no good whatsoever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you, God.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. From the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. This is why a man must leave father and mother, and the two become one body. They are no longer two, therefore, but one body. So then, what God has united, nobody must divide. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise be seated. A very beautiful day outside, sunny, bright, crisp, pure. That is what describes this celebration today too. Beautiful indeed, so bright and so hopeful of things to come. And I wish you all the very best, Brian and Denise. And I'm sure in a few months' time, our loss here in Michigan will be Wisconsin's gain. I tried to find a few things about you, and I think working at Henry Ford Hospital was a blessing for both of you, because that's where you got to know each other, and you kept growing in love for one another as the couple of years went by. And I hope that as years go by, your love for one another keeps on increasing. There is always this big expectation, what we are going to do, what's next, what is coming up. If Brian always anticipates Denise's needs, she will love him more. And naturally, if Denise anticipates Brian's needs, he will love her more. And therefore, in other words, if you put one another first in your hearts and in your mind, your love for one another would be always on the increase. And make sure that you communicate a lot all the time. Whatever is in your heart, bring it up so that if there is sadness, it will be divided. If there is joy, it will be multiplied. And it is beautiful to know that you have a person that you can always trust, a person that you can always love. Similarly, you are always trusted and you are always loved. So this is give and take, which is beautiful indeed. We all need this, we all hunger this special person in our life to understand us, even to sympathize with us when we fail. And how beautiful it is when you have this person for the rest of your life. And that is what marriage is all about. Sharing intimately with the one you love and with the one that loves you so much. I would like to give you one tip, and I hope that you will follow this every day of your lives. Keep God always in your life. Remember that the family that prays together stays together. And therefore, whether it is in the morning, at noon, or at night, always together, raise your minds to God to thank Him for His goodness to you and also to ask Him for more blessings in the future. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
I, Brian, take you, Denise,
to be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Denise, it's your turn. I, Denise, take you, Brian.
I, Denise, take you, Brian.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Lord, bless and consecrate Brian and Denise and their love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other and always remind them of their love through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Say after me, present your finger. Denise, take this ring.
Denise, take this ring.
As a sign.
As a sign.
Of my love.
Of my love.
And fidelity.
And fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Brian, take this ring.
Brian, take this ring.
As a sign.
As a sign.
Of my love.
Of my love.
And fidelity.
And fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
And you may kiss your spouse, and I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Brian and Denise Pauly. Let's give them a big hand.
Come our hands, one hand. Yeah.
Now that we have heard God's word in the Bible and felt his presence in this exchange of vows, let us present to God the Father these petitions for people in the world today.
For our Holy Father on earth, the Pope, all the bishops and the clergy everywhere, that they may lead us to deeper faith in God and a stronger love for others, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our president and all leaders of government, that they be effective in achieving peace and eliminating poverty, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For married persons, that they may continue to give, be able to forgive, and find happiness deepen with the passing of each day, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Denise and Brian, now beginning their life together, that they may have divine assistance at every moment, the constant support of friends, the rich blessing of children, a warm love reaching out to others, and good health until a ripe old age, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, lonely, discouraged, or oppressed, that they may be strengthened by God's help and aided by their friends, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially the relatives and friends of Denise and Brian, and of all present for this wedding, that they may enjoy perfect happiness and total fulfillment in eternal life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For these personal needs, which we mention now in silence, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray, O God, our Father in heaven, your Son taught us to ask, to seek, and to knock. We have just done so, confident that you will now look upon our many needs. Consider our trusting faith, and in your great love, grant these requests, which we present to you through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Please be seated. Now we have the presentation of the gifts.